you, Cassius. The angry spot doth glow on Caesar's brow, and all the rest look like a chidden train.
Casca will, after his sour fashion, tell us what hath proceeded worthy note today.
Calpurnia's cheek is pale, and Cicero looks with such ferret and such fiery eyes as we have seen him in the Capitol, being crossed in conference by some senators.
Casca will tell us what the matter is.
Antonius, let me have men about me that are fat, sleek-headed men, and such as sleeper knights. Yon Cassius has a lean and hungry look. He thinks too much. Such men are dangerous.
Fear him not, Caesar. He is not dangerous.
Would he were fatter. But I fear him not. Yet if my name were liable to fear, I do not know the man I should avoid so soon as that spare Cassius. He reads much. He is a great observer, and he looks quite through the deeds of men. He loves no plays, as thou dost, Antony. He hears no music. Seldom he smiles, and smiles in such a sort as if he mocked himself and scorned his spirit that could be moved to smile at anything. Such men as he be never at heart's ease whilst they behold a greater than themselves. Therefore are they very dangerous. I rather tell thee what is to be feared than what I fear, for always I am Caesar. Come on my right hand, for this ear is deaf, and tell me truly what thou thinkst of him.